So, today is the 4th of July, and what's more 4th of July than pie? And this is a lot of rum. And it peed on me. Also, what's more American than Coke? Zero. Coke. So rum and Coke it is. Woo! Ugh. So what you need for your pie is you need about 6 apples. And then, I did this before I did the, before I started this video because sharp knives and alcohol don't usually mix. I cut up the apples in, it's sticky, half inch wedges. I tossed in 1/4 cup. I need to drink something. I tossed in 1/4 cup of sugar in there and let it drain for about 1.5 hours. My hands are sticky now. So I get a bucket or another bowl, and then I put the sticky apples, they're sticky, into the bowl. Oh, I need to preheat the oven. This oven, you have to put 50 degrees cooler. You just set it for 50 degrees cooler than it actually is supposed to be set for, because for some asinine reason, no wonder everything was burning in there. Jerk. 1/4 cup of sugar. Then, drink. 3 tablespoons of flour. It says tapioca flour, but pfft. And 2 tablespoons of jelly. 1 tablespoon apple cider. Oh, here's the deal. I didn't buy apple cider. Since only she needs 1 tablespoon, I'm gonna use rum. 2 teaspoons of lime juice. And I don't have lime juice, so I have lemon juice. And then it calls for something called grains of paradise. Yeah, we're not gonna do that. We're gonna do some ground cloves. Then we're gonna do some cinnamon. So, and then I'm supposed to toss it. Grease your pie pan. I did the really awesome thing and just bought pie crust. Because who makes their own crust? Not me. So the first pie dough is going to be really normal. And we're just going to plop it in there. And then you push it, and then you push it in there. Like this. Great thing about these things is that it doesn't suck like making pie crusts does. So I'm going to layer this, and then I'll show you the end result. I got some apples. I can only use one hand because I cut myself. And then a I have an assistant, so we'll put a face. Hi. I'm just kind of putting it on there and squishing it down. I got attacked by a spoon. This is what the pie looks like. This is what the pie looks like now. Put your other pie crust. Hi. You put your other pie crust down, and we're gonna do something cool. One through the middle. We're gonna make lattice works. Guys! Then we get the longest ones, and we put those like that. I'm really hot and sweaty. It's sweated down my bra. So if you have an electric stove like I do, put your grate on the lowest possible setting for the first 30 minutes and let your pie bake there. And then you bring it up for 20 more minutes on the rack to above that. So it's been half an hour and you've talked to your mom on the phone. You need to switch where the pie is. Ugh. I snorted accidentally and it went up the wrong, it went up my nasal passage. So you take your little things off. And then you put it back into the oven for 20 more minutes. 20. Hi! That went off, so I gotta get that. So you got an apple pie and it's awesome and done. You need to let this apple pie cool for at least 4 hours.
No!
You have to do it because that will let the pectin and flour inside and the other juices inside the pie set up so that when you cut into it, it won't be a big pukey mess. And then after 4 hours of waiting, you can cut it. Thank you, come again!